Hello everyone, I'm Robert. Welcome back to our Data Management module. In this video, we will be talking about the mutate function from the dplyr package. The mutate function allows us to add new variables to our data frame using the existing variables. We'll first load in our packages, clear the global environment, and load in our Houston flights dataset. So let's get started with the mutate function. The basic syntax is pretty simple. When using the mutate function, we'll first pass in the name of the data frame, and then we'll pass in the name of the new variable that we want to create, followed by an equals sign. On the right side of the equals mark, we'll put an expression specifying how the variable should be created. Also, we can create multiple variables at the same time. The only difference is that we will need to use the comma to separate each of these expressions. So how does this work in practice? Let's look at our first example. In this example, we want to create a new variable called ground time. It's the sum of taxi in plus taxi out. So our expression here would be ground time equals to taxi in plus taxi out. When we use the mutate function, we'll first pass in the data frame name, DAT, and then this whole expression. When we run this, we get our D1. And let's take a look at it. When we scroll to the end of D1, we can see that a new variable called ground time is created. It's added to the end of the dataset. We can check our results by selecting the three columns, taxi in, taxi out, and grid, and ground time from D1 and assign it to D2. When we look at D2, we can clearly see that the ground time column is the sum of taxi in and taxi out. More efficiently, we can use the pipe operator to combine these two commands. So we'll first use the mutate function to create the ground time variable and use the select function to select them. Notice here we don't need to pass the dataset name into these functions when we use the pipe operator. So this is a brief review of our pipe operator, and let's go back to our new function mutate. In this second example, I want to create two new variables at the same time. Aside from the ground time variable, I want to create a new variable called speed. It is equal to distance divided by airtime. So it measures the speed of the flight. Here, the only difference between this slide and the previous example is that we will use a comma to separate these two variables. So after the ground time equation, we will put a comma and put speed equals to distance divided by airtime. When we run this, we get our D4. And let's take a look at D4. When we scroll to the end, we can see two new variables, ground time and speed. Cool. And another common use of the mutate function is to create dummy variables. That means the variables that can only take on a value 1 or 0. It takes a value of 1 if a specific condition is true and 0 otherwise. To create this type of variables, we'll need to use the mutate function plus the if-else conditional statement. So let's first take a look at the if-else statement. It will take in three arguments. First, we will need to pass in an expression. This is the expression that we will be evaluating. And in the second place, we pass in a value, which will be returned if the condition is true. And finally, we'll pass in another value, which will be returned if the condition is not true. To create a dummy variable, we will use the mutate function, and then we will write the variable name as we have done before. However, on the right side of the equals mark, we will no longer have a simple equation. We will now have an if-else statement. Inside the if-else statement, we'll first pass in the expression that we want to evaluate, and then we'll pass in 1, and finally we'll pass in 0. This means that the variable will take on a value of 1 if the expression is true, and 0 otherwise. It's always a very good practice to name the dummy variable consistent with the case in which it equals to 1. So here in this example, we want to know whether a flight arrives late. So the variable will equal to 1 if the flight is late and 0 otherwise. In this case, we will name our variable arrival late. Okay, so how can we create this arrival late variable? In the mutate function, we'll first pass in the dataset name, and then arrival late equals. On the right side, we'll use if-else statement. The condition that we want to test here is whether arrival delay is greater than 0. If it is, that means the flight is late, and it's going to take the dummy variable will take a value of 1. And if not, it will take a value of 0. So this is our if-else statement. When we run this, we get D5. When we look at D5, and we can see that at the end, we have a new dummy variable called arrival late. And we can see that this variable only takes a value of 0 or 1. We can check our results by selecting arrival delay and arrival late, these two variables, and put them into D6. When we look at D6, we can clearly see that the arrival late variable takes a value of 1 if the arrival delay is greater than 0 and 0 otherwise. Okay, cool. This is basically everything for the mutate function, and I will see you guys next time.